What up, y'all? DMB.
Your boy, Bip.
Let's be right to a video about Planet Dolan. This is 15 kids who survived the impossible.
Dang. At least they survived. At least you still got life. So
Yeah, that's good. It's crazy. When stuff happens to people, it's just like, you know, sometimes they'll pass away. Sometimes they'll survive. If you survive, you know, you're stronger than you were before. Man, right. Do something tragic.
And now you know that I can survive anything.
Yeah, yeah. But let's hop into it.
Let's go.
Planet Dolan. When disaster strikes, it is so often children who suffer the most. But just because you're small, does it mean you won't survive? Mm-hmm. Does extreme youth have an advantage in perilous situations? Here are 15 children who survived the impossible. I'm Danger Dolan, and today I will be your narrator.
Number 15.
9-year-old Willie Merrick was hanging out in his driveway one spring afternoon when a stranger caught his attention and forced him into his car. The stranger drove for over 3 hours while Willie, frightened for his life, began singing his favorite gospel song at the top of his voice. The kidnapper shouted at Willie to cut it out, but Willie kept it up until eventually the exacerbated child snatcher stopped the car and freed Willie out of pure annoyance.
Yeah, he was singing
gospel.
That's
good. That's good. At least you're freedom.
14. In 1995, a Colombian farmer heard the sounds of crying from a mound of seaweed in a marsh near Cartagena. The cries came from 10-year-old Erica Delgado, who had miraculously survived a fall from an exploding airplane. As the aircraft broke up in the sky, the girl said her mother had pushed her out of the plane and her 1,000-foot fall had been cushioned by the seaweed. Erica was the only survivor of 50 victims.
Number 13.
After a few minor falls from her young son, Keston, Cynthia became obsessed with the idea that she had allowed him to become permanently brain damaged. Deciding that she couldn't bear the guilt, a psychologically pained Cynthia threw herself from the 8-story window of their New York apartment. Despite being strapped to her in a baby carrier, Keston survived the fall, which tragically killed his mother.
Number 12.
Hey. In 2016, Thomas Richards was born, looking like a normal, healthy baby. But the infant was born without a trachea.
She wanted to kill herself
and was unable to breathe. There's only 5 survivors from 200 cases recorded in all of medical history. Thomas's odds weren't looking very good. The surgeons were able to build separate tubes to both his lungs and stomach using his existing esophagus. With advances in stem cell research, Thomas may find himself with a brand new breathing pipe soon enough.
Number 11.
The Nazi Holocaust of the 30s and 40s took the lives of millions, but within the horror lies some stories of survival. Barbara was born in 1944 on a brick furnace in the camp of Auschwitz. Her mother was near death after her birth, and Barbara was breastfed by a Russian woman who had recently lost her child. Amazingly, Barbara survived the camp, even under the watch of infamous child experimenter, Josef Mengele.
Number 10.
In 2016, in another tragic suicide, father of 2 boys, John Spinkin, climbed onto the roof of his car and leapt off a highway overpass bridge into the forest 100 feet below. He was holding his 1 and 3-year-old sons in his arms as he fell, but both boys escaped the ordeal with a full recovery. Reports suggest a history of domestic violence and recent arguments with his wife.
Number 9.
After getting a split lip playing basketball, Jake Finkbonner didn't think he'd find himself in the hospital, but within 24 hours, Jake's face had been ravaged by a flesh-eating bacteria that was destroying more than an inch of skin every couple of hours.
Ooh.
Told by doctors that Jake didn't have long to live, his parents prayed to Native American Catholic Katari, who is now being considered for sainthood. Shortly after, surgeons were able to eliminate the usually fatal infection.
Number 8.
The notorious funnel web spider is one of the deadliest creatures on the planet.
That thing looks scary.
The bite
can
kill a child in as little as 15 minutes. 10-year-old Matthew Mitchell was bitten on the hand and rushed to hospital. Doctors gave him 12 vials of anti-venom, the biggest dose in Australia's history. The anti-venom was so effective, Matthew was walking out of hospital unscathed a day later.
Number 7.
In 2015, Autumn Veitch had been taken out for a flying trip in her grandparents' small plane, but a problem on board sent the aircraft crashing into the Cascade Mountains. Both grandparents were killed in the crash despite Autumn's efforts to rescue them from the fiery wreckage. She had to hike for 2 days through the wilderness before being found by the side of a highway.
Number 6.
While walking home off the school bus, 14-year-old Elizabeth Shelf was accosted by a man dressed as a policeman. The man, who was in fact an unemployed construction worker, dragged the girl to a bunker near his home in the woods. Enduring 10 days of assault, Elizabeth was able to convince the man to lend her his phone to play games. She sent messages to friends and family, and within a day, police had triangulated her position and rescued her from the nightmare.
Number 5.
An immigrant from Somalia, Yahya Abdi, missed his mother back in Africa. So he decided to hop on the next flight heading west from California. Without the funds for a ticket, he instead clambered up the wheel shaft of the aircraft and survived a 5.5-hour journey to the Hawaii stopover. The freezing temperatures and lack of oxygen would have been enough for most people, but nothing can stop a homesick teen, it seems.
What?
Number 4.
He held onto the wheel the whole time.
His 16th birthday present, Mackenzie Wethington was taken on a skydiving trip in Oklahoma, but an issue with twisted lines prevented the parachute from opening, meaning the teenager performed a free fall of 3,000 feet and hit the ground. To the disbelief of medical professionals, Mackenzie survived, although with several trauma injuries. She's since been awarded $700,000 in damage against the skydiving school, and the minimum age for falling was raised to 18.
Number 3.
In 2009, French schoolgirl Bahia Bakari was on a flight over the Indian Ocean with her mother. The plane crashed into the ocean, killing everyone on board except for Bahia, who was flung into the water. The 12-year-old couldn't swim, so she clung onto debris in the water until she was rescued after 3 hours. She was flown back to France for a bittersweet reunion with her father.
Number 2.
For something that started as an internet meme, it may seem strange that the mythical figure the Slenderman might command enough respect for human sacrifice. But in 2016, two 14-year-old schoolmates lured Peyton Lutner to the woods and stabbed her 19 times, hoping that her death would please the fictional phantom. Peyton recovered fully, while her attackers faced charges of either murder or insanity.
Number 1.
Norman Olistat's father was a real adrenaline junkie, from skiing to surfing to flying. That all ended in 1979 when a light aircraft crashed, killing Norman's father and the pilot. The 11-year-old boy navigated his way down the mountain with his father's girlfriend, but she was killed after a bad fall. Incredibly, the boy made it down the slopes using the skills his deceased father had taught him.
Dang, this is crazy. But at least they all survived, you know?
That's true.
That matters. It was just, like, really bizarre situations. Like,
right. That chick was kidnapped for 10 days, being sexually assaulted, and then the rapist gave her his phone
to play games.
That's what his stupid ass get, though. I hope he's dead.
But yeah, this was a crazy video. Let us know what y'all thought about it. Make sure you
like, subscribe.
We'll see you in the next one. Bye.